Hello! Sunday Funday is back as always. I'm eventually going to start making a song or something for it. But yes, I am back.
Theme song.
Yes, exactly. But I am back with The Great Wall. This actually was going to be a review with at least one other person. I was hoping Megan first was going to be it, but fortunately Megan had to work. She is here as set decoration as always.
Yeah, I'm here just kind of to stand in the audience to just kind of ask questions.
Yeah. And also, the other person who's going to be in this is a very good coworker of mine and a very good friend of mine named Deb. Unfortunately, she was like, I'm not sure. I think, and I'll go ahead and say if she's watching this, like, I think she might have been possibly would be a little nervous in front of the camera, which maybe eventually we will be able to get you to meet her. And that way y'all can, you know, gawk over Deb and everything. Mm-hmm. But I know I'm going to freak y'all out. I'll be like, who the fuck is that? Mm-hmm. Like some random person. It's like, new person. But yes.
Okay, you want to get your...
Yeah, instead of seeing A Cure for Wellness, because I had no shits to give about that movie.
I think that looks so dumb from trailers.
It looks like Shutter Island is what it looks like to me. I see a lot of Shutter Island in that movie. I decided to go see the Matt Damon-led Chinese film, The Great Wall. It's not just Chinese-led because,
takes place in China.
Yeah, not just because of that, but also because of the fact this is a Chinese production group, this is a Chinese director, everything. I really want to say this director originally did Mermaid, is one movie I know he did.
One movie we were watching that one time.
Yeah.
That was so funny. Well,
it was funny, but it made no damn sense. I will let y'all know here in about 5 seconds. Sorry, I'm already on my phone. I'm not going to pronounce this poor man's name because I'm going to butcher it worse than any human should ever do. Oh, no, he did Hero. That's what he's most well known for. For Western audiences. He's done Hero and those who are really into the more mystifying uses of CGI, but they use it for actual mystical stuff, is what I'm trying to hint at, and kind of missing my point. He did House of Flying Daggers, the pretty much kind of like remake thing they did a while back. He's pretty well known for doing these kind of films. I was wrong, he's not the guy who did Mermaid. Mermaid sucked, by the way. It was funny, but it made no sense.
It was funny, including during scenes that I don't think it was meant to be funny.
Yeah. Didn't help a lot. It was going right over that head.
Yeah, it was like half octopus guy. I would say half obstacle.
He was an he was an octopool. There's the word.
Half octopus man, just kind of like that.
Running down a hill. That was pretty weird.
Like, okay, that's a way to travel.
Yeah. Fun. We're talking about that more than we are the Great Wall.
Yeah.
Great Wall, long and short.
Have seen the Mermaid, like, not all the way through.
Well, I watched the rest of it. It's nothing to write home about. It's pretty dull. It also gets very convoluted. But, the reason why it sounds like we're wanting to talk about other movies that are in Great Wall, it's not that Great Wall is a terrible movie or anything like that.
Thankfully for you.
It's a wildly okay movie. Mm-hmm. There is a lot to the movie that is very good. Like, visually, this is a beautiful looking movie. This director has an eye for being able to put together some really good looking scenery. Or scenery, pretty much shots is what I should say. Brandon put words together. Like, he has a lot of the different colored armor, soldiers and everything. Which in the trailer is like, but it actually looks really good on camera. It helps. Like, you have the blue ladies. Yes, they are all ladies, so I can say that. Ha ha. Because they even say, like, men can't do this. Okay, why not? Because they're too fat. All right, cool. You're saying guys are fat. Thanks. Her feelings, man. She can eat them away. But yeah, then you also have the red archers, and they're like, the black guys are the foot troops. Well, what are the purple dudes? What are these other guys that have different kind of armor? The yellow guys, what are they? Well, not trying to be racist, but, you know, yeah, there's actually guys who have yellow armor.
We kind of figured that, honey.
Yeah, like I said, there's a lot of these shots that look very beautiful. The CGI in it is fairly decent. I mean, it's nothing to write home about, but it's nothing that... I don't think it's going to be like an iRobot issue where iRobot just barely 10 years after it originally came out. It looks like dog mess. It's just the biggest pile of turds. It's got a good story, but it's CGI is, oh, God, terrible. But I think this is a movie that will look decent come 10 years. It's not going to be wonderful, but it's not going to be one of those movies that we go, oh. So, like I said, it's a visually good-looking movie. The action in it is very interesting. It's very well done.
Well, what about the story and the acting?
That's the problem. There's no story here. There's nothing here. It's just, it's an action. It goes from one action sequence to another. Deborah, I'm going to really quote her a lot. She pretty much described this as a Warhammer movie. And I would agree with that. It's a Warhammer RTS, a real-time strategy game, for those who do not know the game lingo time. Yeah. This is very much that, because we have the first little battle where we get introduced to Matt Damon and this other guy who I'm afraid I can't remember, but he was funny. He had really good funny lines. Like, he was always little quips here and there. And they were pretty good, usually. I always listen to a little chuckle out of me. But they pretty much are... the main story is Matt Damon's trying to look for gunpowder, him and this guy and this one group of people. They get lost, get in China, fight dragons. There's your story. There's not a whole lot more to it. There's no real backstory to these dragon things, except for the fact they came from this meteor. Okay, well, oh, and they're allergic to magnets. Like, it pretty much disrupts them being able to talk with their queen, which they're trying to kill because of stuff. Eh? Yeah, they don't really explain a whole lot. That's a big problem with this movie. There's a lot of...
So essentially they are aliens.
Yeah, they're in all essence, they're aliens. They are just, you know, big dragon things that came on this meteorite that crashed into this mountain. And they're aliens in all essence. Which is fine. I just would have liked a little bit more of an exploration of it. It would have been interesting to see more what they would do with this. Instead, we got to fit in as much action as possible. And the action's good, but when you don't have a good story to hold it together, you can't invest yourself in it. And that's a problem. A lot of this, I was just like, oh, it just seems to be fighting for fighting's sake. And
Matt, from a dude.
Do what?
Coming from a dude.
Yeah. And after a while, it's just, you kind of just drone. You feel like you're just a movie. And also, it does not help that those who think Matt Damon's delivery is a little flat in the trailers, boy, oh boy, you're not going to be excited with the fact that that's his delivery throughout the whole movie. Everything he says, kind of Shatner-ish. It doesn't make sense. Probably the issue is that he is getting direction from a Chinese director, and if he was to be saying these lines and they were in subtitles, it would make sense. In an American audience, it doesn't make sense to us why he is having these weird pauses, or why he's not really emoting very much. Not trying to...
Maybe he just doesn't give a shit.
Maybe, but it just... Because there are other people who are trying, sort of. Well, Willem Dafoe always puts his all into everything. I have serious questions about why this man puts as much effort as he does in everything he does. Because Willem Dafoe shows up. He's this guy who, I think there was a backstory and they cut it. He's been there for 25 years. Why hasn't he escaped? I don't know.
They're like, where's that movie?
Well, it would have been interesting just to see his backstory. And that's the thing. It felt like a lot of this movie was cut. This probably was a three and a half hour long epic film. Almost Bollywood style in a way. Though it seems stupid saying it that way since it's coming from a Chinese director and Chinese company and everything. Who know how well the Indians and Chinese get along. But... it feels like that's probably what they were going for. And then they're like, well, we're going to release it in American audiences, so we're going to chop it to pieces. Like, there is a story somewhere, but it's not in this film. And that's a big issue throughout this whole thing. You're constantly dealing with the fact there's not really a lot explained. There's not a real sense of urgency, really. Except for, like, at the end, they're like, oh, they're doing stuff. And they're going to do this stuff. And if there's more, they will do more stuff. Okay.
Sounds interesting.
It's like, we do this stuff to kill the stuff that doesn't kill the other stuff. It's like,
Watch, the extended cut is going to come out on DVD. You're going to watch it. And you're going to be amazed.
Because the extended cut's going to probably be longer than Batman vs. Superman. And like I said, it feels kind of mean. And even Deb was saying the same thing. She's like, it's not that I hate this movie. And it feels kind of wrong just talking shit. But it's like, it is a very hollow movie. It's a very beautiful looking movie. Well done action. Everything. Because y'all remember my bitching about Resident Evil Final Chapter. About quick ad. I mean, there was 28 jump or little edits within less than a minute of footage. Less than 30 seconds of footage, in fact. This doesn't have that. It has a very good eye for showing it when it needs to. Slows down when it needs to. But it feels like we're just being shuttled along. Oh, here, we need another action sequence. Let's have that now. Here's another one. Let's have that one. Well, what about the story? Well, there, you get three sentences. Mm-hmm. Like I said, there was probably a film that was shot, and it's a three-hour epic, and I will watch it and probably love it.
I would say, if only we're going for a more aesthetic than anything, and just kind of sacrifice story.
But see, there's the problem is you can... there's a perfect movie analogy that proves that way of directing is wrong.
Yeah.
And that is Mad Max Fury Road. I'm using a very early or very recent example, but Mad Max Fury Road is a beautiful looking movie. I mean, it has some of the best cinematography you have seen, hands down, out of anything. I mean, it is a gorgeous movie.
Yeah, I liked it. I liked the visuals. Even though it has kind of a monochromatic color scheme, and I hate monochromatic color schemes. That's why I don't watch Westerns. It's like, fuck it. Fuck
they're a little dry.
Yeah. And it's like, I want some colors. I want some blues. You know, maybe some purple if you can manage it, please.
Strangely enough, it does accomplish some of that. It does have these random bouts of color that really work, especially with the explosions. Or
yeah, like really kind of contrasts well with like this kind of desert setting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But on top of that, Mad Max has a story.
Yeah.
It's told, yes, mostly through exposition, which people can say, but it doesn't feel like exposition. It feels like characters are talking to each other.
Yeah, it's not just like balls-to-the-wall action just for the sake of balls-to-the-wall action. Mm-hmm. It's balls-to-wall action in the midst of a story actually going on. You know, stuff is actually happening.
Yeah, learn about Furiosa, is that how her name is pronounced?
Furiosa or something like that.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I can't pronounce Charlize Theron's character's name correctly.
And everyone is fucking nuts in that movie.
Mm-hmm, and it's fun.
Especially Beast from...
Yeah.
From X-Men First Class.
And next...
Nicholas Holt.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Nicholas Holt is such a blast in that movie.
Yeah.
He is... obviously having the time of his life. What a day! What a lovely day! Sorry, that movie
is like, how much coke did you sniff or you did the scene?
He is covered in white.
Well.
Yeah, that is a movie that is a visual spectacle. It is a wonder to behold. I would tell people, you can watch it without the sound off, but you are missing something with that movie.
Yeah.
Gray Wall is the exact opposite. You can watch it with the sound off. You don't miss anything. The only big, like, reveal, and it doesn't feel like it means anything, because, again, it feels like a part of the story was, part of the movie was cut out, and that is they learn the magnets disrupt this queen being able to communicate with them, with the drone. But it has to be within very close proximity.
So pretty much they're the Borg.
Closer to that of, I would say, if you've ever played StarCraft, the Zergs. They're the Zerg. They're just these monster things that eat and consume. Mm-hmm. But if you separate them from the Queen, they're not as dangerous as, you know, by themselves. Well, the Zerg don't really have a queen per se, but I'm not going to get into StarCraft lore, because I don't give a shit.
Well, I mean, with the Borg, if you, like, unassimilate, you know, cut the drones off from their queen, then they're nothing without the queen. You know, they return to their individuality.
Actually, no, they just become, like, insanely docile. In fact, when they kill the queen at the end, all of the monsters just kind of, and just fall over dead. It's like, okay, nobody ever thought about doing this till now?
Okay, it movie sounds like it's pretty, but really fucking dumb.
Yeah, it feels like there was a lot of story we were missing. And that's the problem. There's a lot of, like, this is a beautiful looking movie.
Yeah.
I want a story somewhere in here. Where is my story, damn it?
Again, that's coming from a guy.
Yeah, but still, I mean, I want at least something to latch onto. I want some substance to it. Because otherwise, it's like getting an appetizer that is just a little, or it's like the most delicious and beautiful looking piece of toast ever. But that's all you eat. It's like, I need more than that. I need some meat. I need some cheese.
Quit talking about food.
Yeah, we're both hungry, so we're having to talk about food because it's the only thing on my mind.
It's been like nearly 5 hours. Five and a half, something like that. Hours since I've eaten. I am fucking hungry.
I'm going on close to 24, so.
You win. Obviously.
Yeah, again, like I said, this movie, it's a hollow movie. Is it bad? No. That is the one thing I can say. It's like, it's not bad. When the action's good, it's great. When it's beautiful to look at, it's gorgeous. But you're just not going to care. It's hard because I feel like I want to say go see us in theaters because it is a beautiful movie to look at. Maybe if you just really want to see this in theaters, fine with turning your brain off, I would say go see this.
I would say, it sounds like if you prefer, or if you don't at least mind, you know, style over substance, then this may be the movie for you.
Yeah. It feels weird because I'm going to probably grade this a little lower than Underworld Blood Wars. Underworld Blood Wars knew it was stupid. This movie really wanted to be more than what it was.
Wanted to be kind of like, not really highbrow, but just...
It wanted to be better than your modern fantasy film. Yeah. And that's the thing. It's like, at first I was thinking, alright, this is going to be like, this is going to be my Flesh and Blood. Those of you who have never seen Flesh and Blood with Rutger Hauer, directed by Paul Verhoeven, it is a phenomenally fun movie. And it also doesn't make a whole lot of sense either. But it is a fun 80s flick. It is one of those flicks that everybody should see. Fun magic, swords, sandal, people dying, getting chopped left and right. It's awesome. This really wants to be a little higher than that, but at the same time, it doesn't have anywhere near the charm or the story that movie did. It's just what it is. I would say if you want to see it, go see it on a matinee, or if somebody's willing to buy your ticket, be like, yeah, sure, I'll go see this. But if you're just like, oh, I want to see, you know, a movie that's going to stimulate my brain a little bit, this movie's not going to do any of that for you. It's going to look pretty, but you're just not going to care. It is a supermodel. It is your typical supermodel. Beautiful to maybe look at, but... not a whole lot going on inside.
Like, hollow inside.
Yeah. And if I can give it a score, I really think this is a 5. This is a perfect kind of 5 movie. You are not going to hate this. And in fact, I didn't hate this.
I'm not going to love it either.
Yeah, but I can go ahead and tell you, I'm going to forget this movie in like a day or something. I'm going to be like, oh yeah, I saw that.
I was going to say, it's going to seem like one of those movies like, come year's end when we're thinking about, okay, what was the best of this year? What was the worst of this year? You're going to be going through, you know, your YouTube videos like, oh yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, like I was just doing that a little bit last year. Like, there was somebody who was like, oh yeah, that was something I saw.
Yeah, like with Mechanic Resurrection.
Yeah, like, I was like, oh yeah, that was a movie, like, I think.
Oh yeah, we did saw that, yeah.
But, yeah.
Like, I totally forgot about it until going through your YouTube.
Yeah, I'm going to... same thing here. I'm just going to forget this probably existed. Not because, like, it's terrible, but just because there's nothing to remember.
From the sounds of it, that's what's going to happen. Like, you're going to forget about this.
Yeah. I'll be like, did I see that? Oh, yeah, I did. So, yeah, that was Great Wall. That was a great bit.
Horribly meh.
Yeah. This is a meh. Oh, I don't remember what's in... I know what next week is.
This was... You know, at least it was decent. You know, it wasn't bad. It wasn't great either, but...
Then...
It wasn't terrible.
Oh, next week. At least
being thankful for that, I guess.
Because next week I am totally not looking forward to... I finally figured out what we're probably going to be seeing.
Do I dare even ask?
Oh, goody. Just to let y'all know... more trailers I see for this movie, the less and less I'm interested in it. I didn't even like it when I saw the first trailer. We're probably going to go see Get Out. It's like, oh.
That looks so fucking dumb.
Cool. Yeah.
Like, that looks like, you know, white people are evil. You know, just trying to oppress black people. That's what it seems like. I'm sorry, you know,
from the
Key or Peele or whoever thought it up. Yeah, I think it was Peele.
You know, his name is Key Peele. It's Jordan.
Jordan Peele, yeah.
Yeah, Jordan Peele. No, this is... I think it's Key that did this one. I don't know.
Keegan-Michael Key.
Yeah.
It was one of them, too. Like, sorry.
Actually, from the early reviews I have been seeing about this, first off, this is a critical darling, which that always bodes well, but it is a movie so far, actual people who watch it. Jordan Peele is his name.
Yeah, I think it was Peele.
But the actual humans that watch this movie don't like this movie at all. Because it's not very interesting from what I've been hearing. But, yeah, the...
I was like, critics have very weird tastes.
Critics have very single-minded tastes. Like, you will have some critics who only like certain films. Mm-hmm. I try to be open-minded, but I don't always fail. That's the reason why I kind of could almost be considered a critic, but I don't. Like I said, I'm just film horror people. That's all I am. Yeah.
Whore.
Yeah, I know.
A film whore, a demon whore.
Yes. So yeah.
And according to you, if you were a woman, you would be a big slut.
Oh yeah, I know I would be. Y'all better be happy I'm not a female. That would be horrible, horrible news for everybody. Yeah. Great Wall. It's rare mediocre. It's there. It's a movie if you really want to see it.
That happened.
Yeah, it happened. That was the thing. Go see Split. Split was really good. I don't even remember what I watched last week. It's a bad thing.
We saw
Lego Batman. Go see that. That movie's funny. That movie's hilarious. I don't know why I forgot Lego Batman. I'm like, it was a movie.
I was like, yeah, I know. I want to see it with you. The last member
last movie you remember?
Yeah, last movie I remember seeing with you was Monster Trucks for some reason. I wasn't looking at the cover of Jaws, the book.
Yeah, I have Jaws right over there. Yeah, go see Lego Batman. It's better. It's more interesting. It has more of a story than this did, which is kind of an odd thing to think about. Yeah, or go see Split. Split is still damn good.
You're still yet to take me to see that.
I will take you to go see it, or I will rent it on Redbox or in something and let you see it. That way you can do a review yourself, and y'all can know what her opinions are. So just hear her being really, all salty.
I say, it looks really good from what you and your family have been telling me, because all three of y'all went to see it.
Mm-hmm.
To just you and your brother.
Yeah. My mother's a huge James McAvoy fan. I'm like, I'll take you to see it.
Let's just face it. She's got a crush on him.
Mm-hmm.
And blue eyes.
Poor James McAvoy. I'm sorry to pick on you if you ever watch a James McAvoy. Your wife is one ugly. She is one ugly woman, but I'm glad you love her to death.
Well, at least you know he went for what's inside.
Yeah. Ain't much on the outside. It's like, oh.
I feel like I'm going to be struck down. Just struck down where I sit because of this. Like,
yeah.
I don't want to be part of this. Why am I part of this?
Yeah, we just keep vamping because I'm like, I don't have anything else to say about Great Wall. Eh. I'm not looking forward to the movie next week.
I'm not looking forward to it either. I am...
You're going to come with me.
I am almost hoping that I have to work that day. He's like,
nah, you can come with me.
Please, please, make me work.
Yeah, you can come with me. We'll get you out of work just for that. Well, it's either that or we're going to see the other Nicholas Holt movie. It's called Collision. Which, from what I've seen, that movie makes no damn sense.
I think I'd rather see that, whatever it is.
Anthony Hopkins, Nicholas Holt, of course. And a whole lot of other people. And in the movie, Nicholas Holt, or in the trailer, Nicholas Holt is in it for like a frame, and then everything else is Anthony Hopkins.
Mm-hmm.
And he's not even top billed actor. Well, that bodes well for that. So, yeah.
I think I'd rather see that than Get Out.
Get Out, the collision.
Get Out.
So, we'll see you next week. We'll probably Get Out. Shoot me. So, bye-bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.